Hello, this is Jeff at Magical Fruit Toots. In this tutorial, I show you how to create an animated spinning Wordle globe in Photoshop CC. I demonstrate how to show it as a medium resolution video and also how to show it as a small transparent GIF file. Here is a quick summary of the procedures in this tutorial. We'll start out with a Wordle image created on the Wordle website. Text used is from the Gettysburg Address. Then we'll transform it a bit to fill out the image. Next, we'll create a 3D mesh from the layer and apply it to a sphere preset and add a brown background. At this point, you could position and render the image if you are just interested in a flat image. An animation, we'll create an animation and render it to video. If you are interested in a small transparent animated GIF, we can open a new file and import the video and work with the frames to create the GIF. If you are interested in a more detailed tutorial, keep watching this video. To begin the project, we need a word cloud. Browse to wordle.net. You may need a computer or laptop, as most mobile browsers won't work with Wordle. Click Create. Paste in some text. I use the Gettysburg Address. Press Go. A random word cloud will appear. In the Options menu, choose Font. I chose Beryllium as it looks historic. Next, choose Color. I chose Firenze. Then choose Layout. Choose straighter edges and mostly horizontal. I also changed the maximum words to 100. At this point, keep pressing Relayout with current settings in the Layout menu until you find a word cloud that is fairly rectangular with not too much black space at the sides. When you find a good one, click the Save as Ping button. Save the file as wordle.png. Open up the Wordle image in Photoshop. In order for the image to wrap around a sphere properly, it needs to have a width-to-height ratio of 2 to 1. Resize the image to 1000 by 500 at 300 pixels per inch. You can make it any size you like, but the width should be twice the height. Use Select Color Range to select only the letters. Select Shadows. Fuzzy should be 0%. Range 19%. And invert. Copy the selection to a new layer. Name it Letters. Double-click the background layer and name it Black. Fill it with black. Make the letters layer active. Use Edit, Transform, Distort to move letters closer to the center on both the top and the bottom. We do this because letters nearest the top and bottom get squished when wrapped around a sphere. Save your image as a PSD file. Next, we will create the 3D object. Merge the two layers. Choose 3D, New Mesh from Layer, Mesh Preset, Sphere. You should have Layers panel, the 3D panel, and a Properties panel open. If not, choose the missing panels from the Windows menu. First, the Properties panel. than the 3D panel. We need to turn off the shadow if it is active. Choose Infinite Light in the 3D panel. Then in the Properties panel, uncheck the shadow box if it is checked. In the Layers panel, add a new layer below the Letters layer. Name it BG. Change the foreground color to 593E13. Fill the new layer with the foreground color. Use the rectangular marquee tool, set it a fixed ratio of 1:1, to make a square selection around the globe. Then crop out a square containing the globe. Your image is now about 310 by 310 pixels at 300 pixels per inch. The image size should be increased to make it more appropriate for a video. Increase the image size to 720 by 720. Use a resample method of preserve details enlargement. Zoom out a little bit. Next, we will create the animation. Select the Letters layer. If the timeline is not open, choose Windows, Timeline. Then choose Create Video Timeline. Two tracks will be created, one for each layer. Click the Zoom Out Timeline a few times to shrink the tracks. If the tracks are not 4 seconds long, drag them both to 4 seconds. Choose the Letters layer in the Layers panel. On the 3D panel, choose Current View. Then in the Properties panel, choose Top. Then on the 3D panel, choose Sphere. Adjust the panels to show more timeline. Now twirl down the Letters track. Then twirl down the 3D meshes. Make sure the playhead is in the beginning position. The Move tool should be active. Now click the sphere stopwatch. A yellow grid mark will appear. Choose the coordinates icon in the Properties panel. Notice that the middle column degrees is 000. That is our start position. Now drag the playhead to the 1 second position. Choose the coordinates again in the Properties panel. Change the Y degrees to minus 90. So the middle degrees column will now be 0, minus 90, 0. Now drag the playhead to the 2 second position. Then choose the coordinates again in the Properties panel. Change all degrees in the degrees column to 0. Then change them to minus 180, 0, minus 180. If you end up with plus 180, 0, plus 180, that's okay too. Now drag the playhead to the 3 second position. Then choose the coordinates again in the Properties panel. First change them to 0, 0, 0. Then change to 0, 90, 0. Finally, drag the playhead to the 4 second position. Change the middle degrees from 90 degrees to 1 degree. Press Enter. Then change it to 0 degrees. Press Enter again. The 4 second position should be 0, 0, 0. the same as the beginning. That way loops will be smooth. Next, select Current View in the 3D panel. Then choose the 3D camera icon in the Properties panel. Then select Front in the Properties panel. Move the playhead to the beginning position. Play the animation to make sure it's working. To render the video, press the render icon. The render dialog appears. Here are the settings that I used. Press the render button to begin rendering. This is the video that was generated. Next, we'll make an animated GIF file. Open up a new Photoshop file. Make it 200 by 200, 72 pixels per inch. Choose File, Import, Video Frames to Layers. Choose the video just created. Choose Limit to every 4 frames. This will help skip every 4 frames to make the GIF file smaller. You can experiment with this, but the more frames you skip, the choppier the resulting GIF will be. Click OK to accept the settings. Note that a new PSD file, in this case Untitled 6, was created by the import. You can close the original Untitled 1 file, as it is not needed. Also note that the import has changed the image size to 720 by 720. The resolution stayed at 72 pixels per inch. We'll leave this alone for now, as it will be better to reduce the size within the Save for Web dialog later. On the timeline settings, click Delete Animation. Select all layers by pressing Ctrl-Alt-A. Right-click and group from layers. Choose the Magic Wand tool. Make sure Anti-Alias and Sample All Layers is checked. Select the brown background area. Hold down Alt while clicking the new mask icon in the Layers panel. In the timeline settings, click Make Frames from Layers. Press Play Control to view the animation. It seems a little fast, so to slow it down, choose the animation settings, then select All Frames. Once all the frames are selected, choose any one and change the frame time to 0.2 seconds. This will change all the frames to 0.2 seconds. Choose Optimize Animation from the timeline settings. Both bounding box and redundant pixel removal should be checked. Finally, we will save the animation as a GIF file. Make sure the group folder is selected, not the mask. You should know what background you are placing the animation on. If it's a solid color background, make that color your foreground color. In this case, I'm going to display the GIF on a dark blue, number 090 EAA colored background. Choose File, Save for Web to engage the Save for Web dialog. Adjust the zoom level by clicking the minus control once. First, choose GIF as the file type. Now change the color reduction algorithm to perceptual. Change the number of colors to the lowest amount of colors that the image can be and still look good. In this case, I chose 64 colors. Transparency should be checked. Next, choose image size and change it to 200 by 200 pixels. Press Tab. You can make this smaller now if you wish. Change the animation loop to forever. At this point, press the preview button. The animation looks pretty good, but there is some debris around the outside of the circle. We need to add a matte color to the settings. Select matte, then choose foreground color, which we already have changed to dark blue. If you're going to have it on a pattern background, if the pattern is dark, use black as the matte. If the pattern is light, use white as the matte. Finally, click preview again to check how the image looks now. My image size was 311.8K. By decreasing the colors to 32 and the dimensions to 175, I was able to size down to 182.9K, however, at the cost of some quality. Press save and save the file to your drive. Save and close the PSD file. Here is a test web page to demonstrate how the 175 pixel and the 200 pixel GIF files would look on a web page. The page has the same background color, number 090 EAA, as the matte used in creating the GIF files. This concludes the tutorial. Thanks for watching.